Hi, welcome back everyone, and you are watching the conclusion to five things that advanced players have mastered. And this could be the most important point yet. So if you want to find out what it is, stay tuned. When you enter into that advanced player realm, you quickly start to understand how important it is to make your opponent play one more ball, especially in a defensive situation. However, prior to becoming an advanced player, typically what will happen is a player will get put under stress, under duress, put on the run, and they will create an error themselves rather than making their opponent play one more ball. So to learn more about this, let's turn to outside instruction. All right, so I'm out here on the court and I'm gonna show you two ways that you can get your opponent to hit one more ball. But what you have to understand first is that balance is the most important part of this situation. If I am running to a ball and I can barely get to that ball, I'm gonna have to continue to run to be able to stay in balance. Meaning, if I stop abruptly to try to hit, I'm gonna throw myself off of balance, causing myself to miss the shot anyway. The second situation, if I can get there and I have a little more time, even if I'm late on the ball, I can stop and I can set up a little bit more, allowing myself to try to make that shot. So that's what you have to know first. Are you on the dead run or do you have a little bit more time? The first situation that we're going to talk about is on the dead run. When I run out to this ball and I run as fast as I can to get that shot, I'm going to not only have to continue to move, I'm going to use what is called a reverse forehand. The reverse forehand is a shot that swings and it comes up over the same shoulder. And a lot of the time, the player will come out here, hit like this, and they'll throw it up over the same shoulder and they'll kind of turn out. But in this situation, I'm barely getting to the ball, so I'm going to continue to run through it. And I'm going to get in here, I'm going to pull up over my same shoulder, and I'm going to continue to move off of the tennis court. That's the first way to get your opponent to hit one more ball. Why does the reverse forehand work? It works because it allows you to pull up drastically on the ball, creating topspin. It also allows you to hit the ball a little bit later, which when you're on the dead run, the ball tends to get more even with you than staying out in front of you. And by getting it even here, I can still pull up and hit a great shot. The second shot that I'm going to show you. Now this is for one where you have a little bit more time, but you're still barely getting to the ball, or maybe you're even late. What I'm going to do on that situation, I'm going to use is what's called a squash shot. Now to do a squash shot, I'm going to take my grip and put it into the continental, if not slightly an eastern backhand. And I'm going to get out to that ball like this, and I have a little more time, but I'm still hitting the ball a little bit late, which is why I use this squash shot. I'm going to get out here like this, and I'm going to kind of hook around the ball. And when I hook around the ball like that, that allows me to pull the ball back into the court and get my opponent to hit one more ball. These are the two ways that you'll have more success in figuring out how to get your opponent to hit one more shot. And you never know. Maybe you make that last shot and they miss their next. I see that a lot. So you can use the reverse forehand or the squash shot to get your opponent to hit one more ball. So the next time that you get out to play a match, remember how important it is to make your opponent play one more ball. I'm putting all this content together for you so you can improve your tennis game. And in return, I ask that you hit the subscribe button and hit the like button for this video right here. And I will see you again on the next video with a new series.